61st minute. Risto Stoichkov putting it past the Argentinian keeper, Luis Islas. And Stoichkov has his third goal of the tournament. Bulgaria has a 1-0 lead. And
a little complacent, they thought this was going to be a lot easier.
They'll certainly hear it from their fans when this ends. Balakov on the corner for Bulgaria.
Аржентинска чета, при фенски петлета, жално да ридаят, често во играят, заедно да плачат, а Бен с Марадона, често ичко зе и футболна корона. Хайде, Пенев, хайде, Бойбодо, хайде, днес и днес и на мода, време, време, майна стана, измисли хитро, на играта плана, опери играчи, постави задачи и гледай сетне, българи што значи. Гарвайте знаят, гарвайте могат, тъй да заиграят, до света да смаят. Хайде нашите повече голове, повече голове, повече победи, хайде, хайде, никому не вреди, това лято с песен, купа да донесем, гол на гърците, а аржентинците, пет на нигериците и ходе бреде, гол на гърците, два на аржентинците, пет на нигериците и ходе бреде.
And the U.S. team from back in the 1990 World Cup. The one comment coming out of the U.S. team from back in the 1990 World Cup was that the pressure was good for the keeper.
Post, but the cross is not nearly good enough. Easy for the keeper, Mihailov, who has his good days and bad days. He could be inspired or insipid. And now we have another injury, this time at Marangos. Going down. Good stop involved. Doesn't look as if he's too sympathetic. Some puzzle Stoichkov about that.
Well, I think he's saying that, gosh, I was just playing the ball. Buster Dinoff having first
time. Three from the United Arab Emirates draws things to a conclusion. A muscular, physical match between these neighboring rivals. And Risto Stoichkov there, one of those three shots producing the goal from the penalty spot in the fifth minute. Bulgaria 1, Greece 0. The second of the game is presented commercial free by MasterCard. And here's Sirikov with a chance to make it 2. He still might fall for him, the goalkeeper. And it's a penalty kick back for a foul by the goalkeeper on Sirikov. Poor old Atmat Sidis having made the save. Well, the referee then says that he found
job to save the initial shot, but watch as the player for Bulgaria is trying to get up and go after the ball. That's a tackle in football, no question about it. Once again, a marvelous save on a beautiful pass. Ball played low, and now he no longer has sight of the ball. He grabbed a hold of his leg.
Well, goalkeeping errors have been a big...
He lost sight of the ball, therefore he lost attention on the play, and ultimately made just a foolish, novice mistake.
Here's the penalty kick then. Risto Stoichkov, he scored one. He scored again, but when that was taken, I reckon there were about 10 people inside the penalty area. There were Bulgarians and Greeks. Now that was absolutely ridiculous. Well, it will count because it went in, but if he saved it, it would have had to be retaken.
Well, the rules specifically state that nobody is allowed into the penalty area, including the arc at the top of the penalty area. But the only time you will see an official call that play back is if there is a save in fact made, because the Greek players rush well into the penalty area. Just now on the corner of our screen there, we can see them all over the place.
Well, I have to say, I don't think this referee is covering himself in glory. Look at this.
Well, some of the Greek players are like 5 and 6 yards inside the penalty area.
Is left off for them.
looking to work the 1-2. He's done it nicely. This could be a third. It is. Letchkov is the scorer. Bulgaria lead by 3-0. And it's the seventh goal that Greece have conceded in their first World Cup.
Here, Letchkov gets a marvelous return pass on this play as he makes a very effective run, penetrating right down the heart of the middle of the defense for Greece. Watch the give and then the go. Ball being played through the legs of one of the Greek defenders. Letchkov wide open in front of the goal, one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Keeper not getting the advantage of getting very far off of his line before the shot is taken, thereby not having a good angle to try and play and keep the ball out of his goal. They're very clearly working on that, repairing of their goal differential.
Setting up the human barrier, known as the wall, to try and fend off part of the goal on the ensuing free kick. Expect this one as a direct one. And expect a blast from outside. Stoichkov hits in! Great save by the goalkeeper! But in! It's a fourth goal! Primorov is the scorer! Now that is a crucial goal for Bulgaria. Deep into injury time. Greece are going to be beaten 4-0 again, the second time in a row. But how vital will that goal be when they add up the match in Group D?
Well, it is very significant because it works in helping them in favor of their goal differential. Greece playing like a defeated team. They're all concerned with stopping the initial shot. The only man that does that is the goalkeeper. Nobody following back for the Greek team. Bulgarian players able to run onto it, and what a marvelous free kick this is, curling towards the corner. Greek goalkeeper does a marvelous job to make the initial save, not a good job.
For the Garcia Aspe, we play on. Garcia still on the ball. Galindo couldn't get it, and now Bulgaria looks to start its own counterattack with Yordanov with a long ball. Stoichkov. Mexico controlling this game, Bulgaria counterattacking. He stayed in his goal mouth and it didn't matter against Stoichkov.
Lightning quick, it's a quick ball out of midfield. It splits the Mexican defense. Hristo Stoichkov, one of the best attackers in the world. He's onto it, he explodes into the space, and he rips the ball with his left foot into the upper corner over the top of Kapos. But it's the early pass out of the midfield that springs him. He's got space, and now right here he has acceleration on the first touch to get to a better shooting angle. And what a rocket it was up into the top corner of the net.
He is one of the more flamboyant and temperamental players you will find.
He's fiery.
Well, hey, Johan Cruyff is coach at Barcelona, said Stoichkov does wear two shoes, but he really has only